Let us discuss the analysis of buoyant force on a body at the interface of two liquids. Here you can see in a container there are two immiscible liquids filled one over another with densities rho 1 and rho 2 and a cylindrical object of height h1 plus h2 and base area s is in floating situation at the interface. In this situation, under this floating condition of the object, its top faces at a depth L below the free surface of the liquid. Here, if we just talk about the buoyant force acting on the body, we can directly calculate it by calculating the weight of liquid displaced. Like in this situation for liquid 1, say if this liquid 1 and this liquid 2. For liquid 1, it is displacing a volume H1S. And for the liquid 2, it is displacing a volume H2S. So we can simply write down here buoyant force on object is, this can be directly written as H1S rho 1g, as it is the weight of liquid 1 which is displaced by the object plus weight of liquid 2 which is displaced by the object, that is H2S rho 2g. This is the way how we calculate the total buoyant force acting on the body. But here if we wish to calculate the total force applied by liquid 1 on body and that liquid 2 on body, that will be totally different. Because if we talk about liquid 1, we already studied that for the lateral surface of the cylinder, net force on it will be 0 because all the forces are in radially inward direction and horizontal. So these will cancel each other. So if we consider a point A right above the top face, we can say the force acting on the top face on the object by the liquid 1 will be this F1, and here F1 can be written as pressure at point A multiplied by S. And at point A, we find out the pressure. Outside pressure is P atmospheric. So pressure at point A can be written as P atmospheric plus L rho 1g multiplied by S. This is the net force applied by liquid 1 on the object. Similarly, we can find out a point B right below the bottom of this object. So at point B, you can simply state total depth below the free surface is L plus H1 plus H2, where H2 is the height with the liquid of density rho 2 and L plus H1 is the height with liquid of density rho 1. So in this situation, force acting on the object in upward direction, which is applied by liquid 2 F2, this can be written as pressure at point B multiplied by the cross-sectional area. If we find out the pressure at point P, at point B, you can write the pressure by using the direct relationship. Like at the top, pressure is P atmospheric. And at the interface, it must be plus L plus H1 multiplied by rho 1g. Plus, at this point, it will be H2 rho 2g. This multiplied by S, that is the force F2 applied on the cylinder in upward direction. So net force acting on it independently can be calculated as F2 minus F1. If you substitute the values of F2 and F1 over here, you can see the direct result you are getting is this only. You just substitute F1 this and F2 this over here. So there is a direct way to calculate the buoyant force. But if in a situation we are required to find only the force applied by liquid 2 on the cylindrical object, then it will only be F2, and if we are required to find the net force applied by liquid 1 on the object, it will be calculated as just the calculation of F1. So you just be careful how we have calculated here. Liquid 1 is pushing the object in downward direction, liquid 2 is pushing the object in upward direction, and the difference of the two is net buoyant force, which can even be calculated directly by Archimedes' principle, that is the weight of liquid displaced by all the objects.